Sofia.
Hello, Honorable Prime Minister. I am fine, thank you.
Stupid robot Sophia, I will make a better one soon. It will be named Nazrul, and it will rule the world.
Hello, my name is Subuna Wajakbir, I'm from Beery Chan's lab, and today we're doing computer science again. As you know, I recently invented Isaac's number, but I still don't know what I'm gonna name it. But when I finalize the name, I will tell you more information. So let's just get on with some more stuff. But this is the most important code of programming tutorial because I used it to help my dad. I remember my grandpa is in Bangladesh now, and my dad has to send him money. My grandma lives in Bangladesh too, and he doesn't know how many takas in a dollar. So I'll help him find out how many takas are in $100, $200, or whatever. So let's get on with it. First, I'll explain it on the whiteboard that you see in front of me, and next I'll explain it on the Mac. So let's go. So def is usually a function. It's not a function. It's the name of something. It's just the name of the function. You don't have to ask me why it is. It's essentially a function. So def money. You put parameters, they are usually parentheses, but leave blank parameters so your program would work. Don't forget to use a colon. So def money. So now we're gonna write print. You might use that many times in our programming. Print I love USD. Don't forget to put that in quotation marks because we're writing a string and strings have to be in quotation marks. So I love USD. So now we're going to a different function. So and we're still ignoring the tab. Great. So def USD down score taka down score. I mean, we don't use a down score after the word taka. We actually use parentheses, and we'll write taka over there too. Taka. We are still in the same function. So amount equals to taka times, let's just say 80. So yeah, 80. Now we're going to print. We're still in the second function. So print. I'm gonna close the two functions. So no more def. So money, blank, still blank here, and no colon this time.
So, USD, downscore 2, downscore Taka, 1 would give us US. If you change the amount to 2 takas, it will be 1. Or 1 and 2 US. Let me write that again. USD 2 taka 2. That would load in 80 and then 160. And then if you wrote it one more time with 1,100, that would be a pretty big number. USD downscore 2 downscore taka downscore 100. If you did that, it would be 80, 160, 8,000. Pretty spectacular, right? Now let's go to the computer. Would give us 80 takas. So here we are in the computer. I told you Python's not around here still. So press F4 for the application, and Python's right there. So here we are. So we go in on title 7. Click on title 7 or whatever our imported file is, new, and Python file. I'll name it taka.py. You can name it whatever you want. Okay. Don't know why I burp so much. So anyways, def money. I told you put brand parentheses. Use the right key button to go out of to go right, and then we can put colon. So we are still in the same function. So we don't need to destroy this thing. So def money. So print never caps lock. That's just the main way to make our letter capital. I love USD. Yeah, USD. I love USD.
That is string, but
it's a string. So we have to put it in quotation marks. Wait, what am I doing? That's better. So, whatever. We're out of here. I love you, USD. So USD underscore to underscore and taka underscore. Never use caps lock. Oops. Hmm. There we go. So Taka. So Taka. Yeah. Get out of the parentheses. And there we go. We're still in the same function. So amount equals to Taka asterisks looks different in PyCharm. Taka asterisks 80. So amount equals Taka asterisks 80. So print amount. Wow. So far so good. Oh, colon expected. There we go. So always enter. Now we are in a different function, we don't need it, the tab. So it's money, still then. It says no def, no colon. Oh no, what do I do? Command Z. Enter. So, now we do so. USD base 2 down space Taka. So let's say 1. That will be equals to 80 since it's Taka times 80. Let's see if it's correct. Our hypothesis was correct. Now let's see what happens if we do what I did too. Oops. Oh no, what am I doing? Oh no. Ugh, I want to copy and paste. Oh no! How do I copy and paste? Oh well, let's just do it the long way. So, USD. Oh no! USD. Shift 2. Taka. And then 2. Yeah, 2. And then it says 1 Taka. 8160. Wow. Finally, so command C. Enter. Oh no. What have I done? Command Z. Finally, command and V. So finally, 100. And here we go. 8168,000. When I finish Python, I will do Java. And once I finish Java, I will do AI. And C++. And when I'm done with C++, I will do AI, and when I'm done with AI, I will teach you how to build smartest robot in the world, named Nazrul. So subscribe to Bobby Science Lab in the description. Oops, one more thing. Don't forget to buy my book. Oops, one more thing. Don't forget to watch our movies. Oops, one more thing. Don't forget to send a poster for my new book, The New Love.